Since 2022, global military buildups and escalating tensions are rising worldwide. Countries on all continents are expanding and renewing their militaries. This also happens to air forces. Due to this, aircraft manufacturers must pay close attention to this rising market to not miss an opportunity for profit. And the Brazilian Embraer is clearly leading here with its new C-390 Millennium. While the aircraft has been flying for a few years, now its sales are booming, and that's not even a small part of its potential. So what makes this plane so unique? Everything from its performance range and capacity to cruising speed and price. But before you learn everything about this aircraft, we need to see some background of this Brazilian masterpiece and analyze what the current situation in military aviation looks like. For decades, Lockheed C-130 Hercules has been the most popular military cargo transporter. Since its introduction into service in 1956, more than 2,500 planes have been built, and they serve in 63 countries on all continents, of course except Antarctica. C-130 was the true revolution back in 1950. It replaced smaller piston aircraft that were prone to failures and no longer sufficient for military requirements. And C-130 turned out to be a success. The aircraft proved itself. It was used in multiple conflicts and during many natural disasters to help people. But after 50 years, it was time to think about the replacement. And here we come to our C-390. In early 2000, Brazilian aircraft manufacturer that had just introduced their, as we know today, extremely successful E-Jet family became interested in developing its own medium-sized transport aircraft. The initial idea was to build it as a derivative of the existing E-190, but with slightly modified fuselage and high wings. Embraer also planned to use a GE CF-34 engine to propel this plane, but this has changed since then. In April 2007, Embraer publicly stated that it was studying a medium-sized airlifter. 1 year later, in May 2008, the Brazilian Congress released 800 million Brazilian reais, or $440 million, to be invested in the project and fund the aircraft's development. The budget expanded even more, as in 2009, the Brazilian Air Force signed a deal for $1.5 billion to develop the new military transporter. In the following months, countries such as Chile, Argentina, Colombia, and Portugal decided to join the project. What makes the whole story even more interesting is the fact that in 2012, Embraer signed an agreement with Boeing that later agreed to promote the aircraft around the world. In 2019, it was even announced that Boeing and Embraer were to form a new joint venture company to promote and develop new markets for the C-390 Millennium. However, a year later, Boeing withdrew from the contract following MAX crashes and grounding, as well as the overall bad situation of the aviation industry. The C-390 Millennium was issued with Brazilian civil type certification after 3 years of intense testing. However, the full operational capability was reached at the end of March 2023 when the aircraft received a final type certificate. From this moment, it started regular service with the Brazilian Air Force. Enough history, now let's see what makes this aircraft stand out. The first thing is range. Embraer claims that the C-390 can fly up to 5,820 kilometers or 3,140 nautical miles with 14 tons of payload. To compare, the C-130 can reach only 3,800 kilometers or 2,000 nautical miles. That allows the new Embraer transporter to reach North America departing from Central Europe. The aircraft can be, of course, refueled in the air or even serve as an air tanker itself, which makes it even more versatile. The next up is speed. The C-390 flies up to 988 kilometers per hour or 614 miles per hour. Cruise speed is slightly lower and stands at 870 kilometers per hour or 540 miles per hour. Nevertheless, it's the fastest military transporter, with the C-130 flying at only 540 and a much bigger Airbus A400 at 780 kilometers per hour. This makes it unmatched in this important category, as every military wants to transport things in the fastest way possible. Embraer itself claims that the C-390 is 40% faster than a typical turboprop airlifter. Even though the Embraer C-390 may not look like the biggest plane, it can fit up to 26 metric tons of cargo load. To compare, the aging Hercules can only take up to 19 metric tons. This huge load possibility allows the C-390 to carry more than 80 passengers, or 66 paratroopers, or 7 pallets, or 3 Humvees vehicles, and finally even a Black Hawk helicopter. To facilitate the boarding of taller vehicles, the C-390 Millennium is equipped with a long cargo ramp, which reduces the cargo loading and unloading angle and speeds up turnaround on the ground as time matters to the military. The Embraer military jet can also take part in firefighting missions. Now we will have a closer look at the design of the military Embraer. Thanks to high-placed wings and engines, it can withstand operations from semi-prepared and damaged runways, as well as in harsh environments, varying from the hot and humid Amazon forest down to the freezing cold Antarctic continent, as well as in hot and sandy desert conditions. The engines themselves are the popular International Aero Engines V2500s, which are also used in the A320 CEO family. Thanks to this fact, engines can get replaced or repaired almost everywhere due to the high spare parts availability. They are also mounted in a forward elevated position to prevent the intake of debris. The Embraer C-390 Millennium can be reconfigured for all missions in 3 hours or less, which makes it extremely useful for air forces around the world. The next thing that catches the eye is modernity. The C-390 uses a glass cockpit and fly-by-wire system. The cockpit is similar to the one installed in the newest E2 family of the popular E-Jet. This clearly leaves the C-130 Hercules behind, as the aircraft has far less advanced technology in the cockpit, and even the modernization of the C-130H variant cockpit can't stop it from losing in this field. The price is another factor that works to the advantage of this aircraft. Acquiring Embraer C-390 comes at a cost of around $85 million. Hercules costs more than $100 million, and the larger A400M is around $165 million. However, the C-130 is still dominant in the medium airlift market, mainly due to its reputation and popularity around the world. But Embraer seems to not be worried about this, as the company estimates that in the long term, even 3,500 airlifters might be needed, and they will be worth several billions of dollars. So the future is very bright for C-390. Currently, the aircraft has been ordered or is used by Brazil, Portugal, Hungary, the Netherlands, Austria, and South Korea. And the list will expand quickly as Embraer is working on deals with multiple countries at the same time. The only problem for now is production speed, as currently only 4 units can be manufactured per year. But this is set to expand to 18 in 2030. So Embraer C-390 will be seen more and more frequently in the world's skies. As time flies and the C-130 Hercules ages up, the Brazilian airlifter will increase its market share and continue to get new customers. And it's a no-brainer, as all specifications speak in favor of this aircraft. The need for a quick and versatile military transporter will always be there, and Embraer will take advantage of it. Thanks for watching. Please support and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.